there. Welcome to my ABC Dab.
My name is Craig, and this here is
Elliot.
In today's video, Elliot and I are going to be working on a missing number worksheet. We hope you join us for that, and let's get
started.
Okay, so here are 10 missing numbers that Elliot and I worked with in episode 3 of the Hundreds Chart. And now Elliot and I are going to fill in the missing numbers. There's two versions. I have the version where I just need to print in the numbers, and Elliot has a version where he can choose one of three methods. The first method is to just print missing numbers in to the boxes where they need to go, and then cross them out as he records them. Number two is draw a line from the number squares to the missing numbers. Or number three is to cut out number squares and glue them onto the hundreds chart. Which one would you like to do? Number one, two, or three?
Print them.
Okay, so let's do that. You point to the numbers that you know and then call them out. If you need some help, then you can ask me, okay?
10. 2 and 9.
And the other ones you are still working on. So this one here is called 28. This one here is called 15. This one is 22.
I know which one.
What's that one?
25.
It is 25.
This one is 20.
This one is 20. This one is 18. And this one is
24.
Okay, so whatever you want to choose first, you can choose whichever numbers, maybe the numbers you know already, you can choose and then print them where they need to go and cross them out as you go. And as you do each, I'm going to follow your lead, okay? So which one are you going to do first? 10. And then you cross out which one you've done already so you don't get confused. Yeah. There we go. That helps keep track, helps you keep track of which ones you've done. Which one do you want to try next? What's that number again?
2. 2,
okay. That goes right after number 1. Okay. So we finished 2 and 10. What's next? Which one would you like to try next?
9.
Now, how do you know the 9 goes there? What could you do to check?
Because I know that 9 is before 10.
You know that 9 is before 10. Okay, lovely. So cross the 9 out there to help keep track. Okay, which number would you like to try next? 22. So how could you decide where number 22 goes? It goes there. How did you know that?
Because here are 1.
Okay.
Here are 2.
I see. So you're looking at 2, 12, and 22. So there's a pattern there. Lovely.
And here there's all 1. Here are 2. And here are 3.
I see. Okay. That's an interesting discovery.
Then
those are all the 10s.
They're all 10.
Okay. And cross out that so we know which one you've done. Great. Which one next would you like to?
24.
24. Okay. Where does 24 go? Right there.
I counted your, the ones.
Okay. Could you also count from here? 21. What's this one?
22, 23, 24.
Ah, so that comes next after 23 as well. Okay, so we have 4 left.
It's from 25.
Okay, where will 25 go?
Here.
Right there. And it comes after 21, 22, 23.
24, 25.
Where does 18 go?
here.
And what's the very last number? What could you do to figure out what it is with this information here? How could you tell what that number is called?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
15, okay. Okay, so you've finished all 10 missing numbers. Nice job, Ellie. Okay, so that concludes this video session today where Elliot and I completed missing numbers from a hundreds chart. If you'd like to download the activity, then please visit www.mybcdad.com and we will
see you soon. Bye.
Bye.